Good morning and welcome to day two of our New York trip. Welcome to a very miserable morning. It's a little bit cloudy on there today. Look at those views. We ended up going to sleep last night at like 10 o'clock. Woke up about 5:30, so I don't feel like the jet lag's kicked us too badly. Just a little bit. But I wanted to be up at 6 anyway. We're off out now. And where are we going, Mum?
We're going to Ellen Stardust Diner for breakfast.
We wanted to be there for 7 o'clock. It's now 7:15. We've not done very well. I forgot what I was saying.
Quite busy, but
that's it. It gets quite busy, so we wanted to get there right when it opened, so we didn't have to queue for too long. But we took too long getting ready. And then what are we doing after?
Is it Radio City?
That's it.
Today?
We were gonna go to the top of the rock, but because of how cloudy it is, I don't want to do that today. So we're gonna wait until it's a bit brighter. We're gonna go and do the tour at the Radio City, and I'm very excited for that. And then we're going to find out all of the photo spots, like the Friends apartment, Cornelia Street, Ghostbusters. Where else was it?
Shall I go and get our list?
Yeah,
handy list. Friends apartment, Cornelia Street, Waverley Place, Washington Square Park,
yeah.
Ghostbusters Fire Station.
That's it.
We've also got potentially Carlos Bakery in New Jersey.
Let's go get into that queue at Ellen Stardust Diner because we're going to be there for hours if we don't go soon.
Yeah.
Right, so we're just into Ellen Stardust Diner, which was incredible. I had rainbow bagels with bacon. Mum had create your own omelette, I think.
Yes.
It's very yummy, very good. We've now come to Times Square, which I was holding off for all of yesterday. But now we're here.
We might as well think
I'm quite in my element. Like, look at it. There's a lot of people trying to sell us things. The mum's getting very stressed by it. So I gotta teach her the art of being rude. And of course she's gonna jump at the Disney store. Because, you know, when there isn't one in Birmingham anymore, you've got two. And I think Mrs. Rowan when it's gonna go. Everything is so cute. I miss being in the Disney bubble. There's so many cute things. Okay, let's be real, the first thing we found is the Statue of Liberty Minnie Mouse. And I really wanna. Like, look how cute she is. It's that or the little tourist Mickey. Oh. It doesn't say how much she is, does it? I'm not gonna buy it. I have officially got a basket now. I have only put one thing in it. We've lost Mum to, I don't know whose gift this is going to be. Who's this for?
I'm checking the deckers of this Spider-Man.
Mum really likes this spirit jersey. Red has been greatly disappointed by the price tag of the Spirit jerseys, haven't you?
Yes, they're a bit much. But they're purple and I like purple.
Yeah. It's cute though. Right, so we've just been shopping in the Disney store. Treating myself to I didn't treat myself. Mum treated me to some plush and some ears. And now we're attempting to get tickets to go do a tour of Radio City. And I'm very excited for it. This is one of the things that I really wanted to do. So I hope we have tickets. We should be okay. I imagine we're okay. It doesn't open for like another 20 minutes, so fingers crossed, we're good. I really think you can see it very well from here on the camera, but
what have we done all morning? We have been very productive this morning. We've been up to Ellen Stardust Diner and had practically a Broadway show with our breakfast, which was very good. The singers were just absolutely stunning. In the Radio City store, she was absolutely magnificent, and met the lovely Maddie who took us round, and she was really, really good and very, very knowledgeable about where we were and everything else. It was just lovely. It was just an astounding building to visit. I was just absolutely mesmerised.
So one of the things you can do with your Go City Pass, you can go to the Radio City Music Hall and there's like a guided tour inside, and it's beautiful. It was, you can't really video when you're in there, so all I've done is taken photos, so there's no clips of it, so you can't tell what we've just done. But it was really mesmerising. There's so many shows that happened there. We even got to meet one of the Rockettes, which that entertained me far more than it should have. But it was a really good hour of something to do.
Dealt with the subway to get us back to the hotel for a brief pit stop. We dropped off a couple of bags so that we're a little bit lighter loaded, ready for this afternoon. And we're now in Washington.
We've now gone to Washington Square Park to have a look around.
Yeah.
We're in Greenwich Village. We're going to go find all of the hotspots, get some more photos. We've ended up sitting down an hour. I don't think I can get up. I also think I need food because I'm getting hangry. So we've managed to get some food at Murray's Mac and Cheese. Can confirm. Beautiful mac and cheese. Absolutely gorgeous. We've managed to walk down Cornelia Street, but it was far too quiet that I didn't want to talk or do anything. And now we're on our way to the friend's apartment. And I might cry. I think it's down this one. It might not be down this one. I think I'm going in the right direction. I could be wrong. Can confirm. I do not know where we're going. I keep turning. My map's off so I can confidently walk somewhere and then forgetting what direction we've actually got to go into. Oh, I know where we are. We're here. I see it. We're approaching it.
Lazy Sunday mornings, hiding under covers. I don't mind staying in with you.
Playing it there.
Playing beside me.
Ta-da!
Just us two, the corner coffee shop we like to go. Late night walks with you to take.
There's not much I can do from here, really, is there? Except for
with you,
videoing.
I never feel alone.
These little songs make me glad to call you.
One last little.
And you, I've got my
head.
Okay.
So we're back on the tour of fire stations, but this time it's the Ghostbusters one. I don't think this one... Is this one even working?
It
doesn't look like it is, but I feel like it is. Very strange. But yeah, from the Ghostbusters film. I don't know, I think it's pretty cool.
This could... They could have chosen any particular fire station, couldn't they?
Yeah.
And it's like, how...
Why did they choose this one?
Why did they choose that one over any other, and then becomes really iconic, and it's just on any other street corner, really.
It's the same as all of them, isn't it? There is like a location person that scouts it out, so they clearly know. They know what they're on about, don't they? Because it's pretty cool.
It is.
Because you were quite mesmerised by the
8 o'clock and ladder 8.
You were quite mesmerised by the friend's apartment as well.
Yeah.
Actually, you were more bothered that there wasn't any green in it.
Well, I was just such a, I seem to recall it at some point being painted.
That was 25 years ago.
Yeah.
Not much better, but you gotta work with what you can work with. It's been a hot minute since we caught up, hasn't it? It's been one hell of a busy day. It's only 9 o'clock, and as you can see, I am showered and dressed for bed because I am knackered. It was attempting to go to the rooftop bar and go have a drink and go have a look over the city, but with the hotel that we're staying in, you have to pop your card on like a card reader and then press the level that you want to go to. That also gives you access to the rooftop bar, which I didn't even realise we had until obviously when we got here. But I didn't even know we had a rooftop bar until my mum recommended that we check it out earlier this evening. We tapped the card on the card reader and tried to press the roof and it didn't work, and we ended up on like a bit of a a bit of a roller coaster onto the lift. We ended up and down so many times, but not to the roof. Then we attempted to go through the fire exit stairs, thinking there was an access door there, but there wasn't. We come back to the room, which I'm quite happy about because I needed a shower. I don't think Mum's too impressed. She has gone downstairs to go get us some drinks. Bearing in mind, we're on the 34th floor, and she's gone all the way downstairs to go get some drinks. But I've needed this. I needed to shower, I needed to clean, I needed to climb into bed. I didn't think that I was someone that really got affected by jet lag. Usually I can power through. Today I have been a right grump, and I realised that I haven't caught you up on anything really that we've done. I've taken a couple of clips here and there, but I haven't really spoken to you. And that's probably because we haven't had time to. It has been a busy old day. So this morning we went to Ellen Stardust Diner. Great, incredible. My rainbow bagel was to die for. I'm really sad that I didn't eat all of it, but I kind of knew my limit and didn't want to get too stodgy for the rest of the day. Then we had one around Times Square, that was really nice. I was a little bit disappointed by the Disney store, not gonna lie. I was expecting more, and I didn't get a lot. I was expecting more New York specialties, and I didn't get a lot. And also the cast members weren't very friendly, and I know. But as an ex-cast member, my standards are high, but it's fine. I got a really cute Statue of Liberty Minnie Mouse, which I'm going to cuddle up to tonight. Then we went to Radio City Musical, and I don't really think I explained it because I got a little bit tongue-tied when I tried to earlier on. But essentially, what you can do, and you can buy it separately, but we've done it with the Go City passes. We've bought 6 experiences, and it just allows us to kind of go here, there, and everywhere, wherever we want to go. We've used the Go City pass to go to the Radio City Musical. I've been a fan of the Rockettes for a while. I don't know how I came about it. I found them, I think, just randomly on YouTube. And I've seen the Christmas Spectacular, like, clips floating around. And I'm just mesmerised by the talent that they've got. Me and Mum have been going to the same dance school since I was 8 years old. They're the most joyful people that I know. I love my dance school. And wanting to see or experience anything to do with the Rockettes was kind of something that I was like, we need to do it while we're here. And obviously, the Rockettes only perform at Christmas. We're not in Christmas, we're in February. But with the Go City passes, you can go on the tour and you basically get like a backstage tour of Radio City Musical. I didn't realise any of the backstory to it, so it was telling you how long ago it was built, which was like 92 years ago. All of the artwork is still like the same artwork. The reason behind it was just to give people this like entertainment level, and it was kind of there before cinema and TV, and it just sounds amazing. The Rockettes have been there for nearly all of that time, and the Christmas Spectacular, and one of the particular dancers, which is the Nutcrackers, and they all kind of like fall down one by one and then all collapse together. I'll try and find a clip to show you because you need to see this. It's so good. But we got to go and have this backstage tour. We got to see everything, experience how the room works and how like how many seats are there. There was like 5,000 seats or something. The stage actually has levels, like the stage can move in levels. It's not just one flat stage. It also can turn the way that the curtains can move and everything like that. It's just, I can't believe I've been in that room now. But the music hall has been host of award shows, award ceremonies, premieres, all of that sort of thing. So it's like, oh god, I sat in the same room as all of these people. And that was pretty cool. And then the last thing that we got to do while we were there was meet one of the Rockettes. And I literally was like, I'm fangirling so hard. She'd been there for like 13 seasons and she was so friendly, so nice. And then we all got to have a picture opportunity with her, which I thought was really cool. Everyone else just kind of did it and I was there like, oh my god. And then I think by that point we then came back, dropped off some stuff, went down to Greenwich Village. There was a couple of photo spots that I wanted to check out. We went to Washington Square Park. Mum couldn't figure it out where it was from or what it was part of, and I completely blanked on any of the movies or TV shows that it's been a part of. I was like, it's a famous park. And that's all I could explain. We then managed to go find Cornelia Street for the Taylor Swift fan in me. We also then went to the Friends apartment for the Friends fan in me. Then we went to the Waverly Place for the Wizards of Waverly Place fan in me. It was really good. Mum has returned from her wonders of getting drinks for the room. We also have the Target snack still and the cookies from this morning. We went to Magnolia Bakery earlier. We got a cookie. I didn't eat it because we had to go to the Radio City Music Hall tour. We can have those tonight and we can finish watching Cocktail, which is what we've got on the telly right now. Can't we?
Yes, we can.
Yes, we can. Filling in on the day and I got to Waverly Place. Where did we go from there? We had really nice mac and cheese from Murray's Mac and Cheese, which is literally opposite Cornelia Street. And I found it quite entertaining that I was the one that had dragged you along, Mum, to go to Cornelia Street. So I was like, Taylor Swift. And then there was a lady next to us with her younger daughter. And was the girl was like, Taylor Swift! And I was like, it's just that thing. So then from there, we went to
the Ghostbusters Firehouse.
We went to the Ghostbusters Firehouse, I forgot about that. I'm sure it's a working firehouse, but the shutters were shut, and it wasn't until later on today that I found out that even when the shutters are shut, we can still attempt to get to see if they're in and ring a doorbell or just knock the door. So we will try and do that by some point at the end of the next few days. And then from there, we attempted to go to Hoboken to go to Carlos Bakery. So if anyone's ever watched Cake Boss, which I believe was on TLC, I wanted to go to the original bakery. There's literally one on Times Square, so like 2 minutes away from us. But I really wanted to go to the original one. I wanted to experience it. And maybe bump into Buddy. The train over to New Jersey was a bit more complicated than getting the subway. So after almost tears on my part because I was getting stressed, we called it quits. We're going to attempt it again tomorrow, but it's okay. We also went to
the World Trade Center sites. We didn't go into the museum thing, but we did see
the memorial.
The memorial. Very highly emotional. Mm-hmm. Very reflective.
We attempted another fire station, which was the Firehouse 10, which is the firehouse that is literally a stone's throw from the World Trade Centers. And we wanted to get those t-shirts, but they didn't answer the door, and then I'm fairly certain an alarm started blaring, so they were about to come out of the station anyway, and we ended up at a place called Lombardi's. I think you're asking why it was such a big deal or how Sean found it. Mm-hmm. But the reason why Sean knew about it, it was America's first pizzeria.
Oh, right. That's the reason.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I made a very poor judgment call and decided to try a new flavour of pizza instead of going for my standard margarita, and didn't like it. Lessons learnt. Stick to what you know. No one should judge me for that in the future. So now I think we might as well eat our snacks, enjoy what's on the telly, and have an early-ish night ready for tomorrow. Good night.